My name is Peter, and I'm going to teach you how to make nice websites. Okay, if you're here, I'm excited to have you. Honestly, I'm excited to be talking to you, and I'm going to take you through all the processes of knowing how to build your own website. Okay, if you're here, I'll take it that you have your business or you're planning to have your own business. So, you might be asking, why do we need this course? No, one of the reasons that you help you save expenses, you don't need to pay any website developer to create a website for you. Two, cheap advertising, it gives you exposure. Three, it increases your sales. It builds trust and relationship with your clients, and also you can build for others. Okay. Alright, on your screen, I know you can see the things you learn. Okay, now let's get all started. The first thing you're going to be learning how to pick a domain. Yes, do you know what a domain is? Well, a domain name is just an address, okay, that address you put on your browser, okay, that takes you to the website you want to go, like, just like you type facebook.com and it takes you to Facebook. That's, you know, text you put, that is known as a domain. So you're going to be learning how to pick domains, because there are a lot of domain companies out there. So you're going to pick a domain name. First of all, you have to pick a name that is coming, because once you pick the name, you cannot change. Okay, you have to pick a name that really, really speaks about your business. If you're a personal brand, you put your name there. If it's a business brand, you put your business name. Okay, and also you're going to be learning the hosting platform to choose. A web host is a place where your website lives. Okay. The host is like a home to your website, so that's what web hosting means. Anyway, you hear web hosting, you should understand it's talking about where your website stays. So we're going to be teaching you the best hosting platform. There are lots of platforms out there. We have Bluehost, we have HostGator, we have Namecheap. Namecheap also does web hosting. There is web.com. There is in Nigeria, there are also lots of web host companies, but I won't recommend Nigeria hosting platform. Although there are some that are good, like Hugo Host, something like that. Is it Hugo Host or Host King or something like that? No? I don't know. I don't patronize them, but their bundles are very cheap. Their packages are very, very cheap. For 300 now, you can get a host and free domain. They'll give you a free domain and you get a host 300 naira a month. Okay, just calculate times 12. So it's very cheap and very affordable. And next, you're going to be knowing the basic of cPanel. What is cPanel? cPanel is the back end. Okay, it is the back end of your website. I've discovered that lots of website owners don't know much about cPanel. It's awful, honestly, because it's a control panel that controls everything. Okay, and the reason why you need to learn this, just for instance, something happened to me some time ago. I tried to log into my WordPress site, that was about last year. If I tried to log in, it didn't log in, it was showing error, but I knew about how all these things work, so I was also surprised. I didn't panic. I went to my cPanel, I did some tweaking there, and I was able to deactivate whatever that is causing and that is obstructing me from logging in. So some people don't know all these things. They find it in a big problem when their website is not functional, their website is broken, and the next thing they do, they hire a web developer, and the web developer will probably charge them $50 per hour or maybe even more, and because, and it's something you can just do less than 5 minutes. So that's how expensive ignorance can be. So I'm going to be teaching you the basic about your cPanel. From your cPanel, you can make subdomains. I don't know if you have heard of subdomain before. For instance, maybe you have heard of adwords.google.com. It's a subdomain. Okay, you have heard of business.facebook.com. It's a domain under a domain. Okay, you know, all those things are in the cPanel. How to install WordPress. You're also going to be learning how to install WordPress. Actually, you might be asking, what is WordPress? I must tell that WordPress is a CMS. A CMS is a content management system. A content management system. And this helps you to manage your website. Your website context is going to be helping you to manage your website context. You'll be able to, because in the olden days, let me say the olden days, before website became much popular, more popular than it is now, people don't have all these softwares. What they do, they code from scratch. You have your HTML, you have your CSS, you build your HTML site, your HTML code, sorry, and then you build your, you link it to your CSS, and you have your website. And some of them use Dreamweaver, some of them use Text, and the like of them. But now, if it's then, that's a lot of people then couldn't have a website. You have to hire a web developer. Now, WordPress has made it so easy, okay? You don't need that. You just a click, you do all the settings, okay? So you need to understand that also, that how to install your WordPress site. I'll take you through all the processes, how to install your WordPress site, and also the interface of WordPress. Yes, this is very confusing. When I started, you know, I happened to learn WordPress myself, and it was one of the hardest things I've ever done. A lot of trial and errors, okay? And you're not going to go through the pains I went through. For 3 months, I was just struggling to figure things out. It was so stressful. I'll make this mistake. You know, one thing about having different tutorials on YouTube, that's why it's not advisable to go on YouTube to learn something in detail. If you just surface learning, it's okay. But the detailed learning, you need tutorial, paid tutorials to learn it. Because you hear this person tell you, do it like this. This is the best. This person, do it like this. Like, at the end, you get confused. I sleep 3 hours every day. But at the end, I figured everything out. The pains I went through. And that's just disadvantage. So you won't go through what I went through. Editing codes. Some people are scared of codes. Well, we're not going to go into details of codes. So if that's what you're scared of, I'm just going to be teaching you how to tweak codes. Okay. Just as I said earlier, and also some website owners. I can tell you that many of the website owners I've seen and I've met, that are some of them my friends. They don't know any single line of codes. They don't know anything about coding. Some of them build sites for other people. They don't even know codes. So you don't need codes, but it's necessary you have the basic of them, because there are some things they are limited to. You can learn how to edit codes and add code snippet to your source file. You might need to add analytics and a Google AdWords to your site, and you need to edit. Okay, we're going to the next one right away. I don't want to waste too much of our time. So SEO setting. SEO simply means search engine optimization. This is actually a way to rank on Google. No, the mistake most people make, even me, I made that mistake when I say build a site. I thought the main just build your site, you start getting traffic. By the way, traffic actually means visitors. So I thought I would just right away, I started having visitors from different part of the world. I waited for like 2 months of the before I started. And sometimes when I have a visitor, there I might have just 2 visitors. I didn't know much about search engine optimization. I started learning it. I learned it the wrong way. There are some settings, the way you set your site, and that it can repel visitors on Google. And Google is one of the ways to get free traffic. Try looking for free traffic on Google. If you can rank well on Google, you don't even need Facebook ads. All these Facebook ads, people are running up and down. If you have enough traffic, you don't need much of Facebook ad, because people will search you on Google and they will get you. Just imagine, if you type let's say creativity on Google, there are lots of websites going to be coming out that will surface out from that keyword. You might see millions of websites. So how do you rank? How do you compete with them? So the trick is SEO, payment gateway. This one is relevant to WooCommerce, especially if it's you're owning your own store online, any type of store, whatever you are selling on your website. You plan to have a website to sell something or give a service, you need a payment gateway. Payment gateway, just say, I know we have heard of InterSwitch, Quickteller, the rest. Most of us have shopped on Jumia, we have seen all those things. Those are payment gateway. You just make payment online, enter a payment. I'm going to teach you how to integrate it to your website. So I'll teach you how to also integrate the Paystock. Paystock is one of the most popular. If our people, Paystock is, to me, is the best for beginners in Nigeria. Using analytics. Now, this is just data. Analytics is just a way of tracking your website. You track the people who visit your website, the pages they visit, how long they stayed, how often they come, how many people a day, how many people per month. This is what helps you to track them. Most people don't even track their visitors. You don't know who comes to your website. You don't know the pages they visit. All these are data that can help you improve your sales, improve your business to the next level. I'm surprised. Even I was doing it for a friend some time ago. He doesn't even know what analytics are, and I was so surprised. How will you know your How will you appraise your performance if you don't have analytics? So I'm going to be teaching you how to actually set up analytics. It's a very stressful one, but I'll put it through. Okay, anything for my people. Things you need to build a website. Things you need. Okay, I've said them before, and I'm just going to say them again. First of all, you're going to need a domain, and you're also going to be needing a host. Like I said, a domain is the address. The host is the house. That's the domain, and okay, the host. They are just like husband and wife. Okay, it's like having a house without address. So you need a house. Have you seen an address without a house? So this goes along. I had someone that said that I have a website, but I don't have a domain. I said you don't have a website now. You don't have a website. It was freaking half a website, no domain. Those are very important. Okay, outline fun. Online store. Okay, so we have talked about domain and host. We can't overemphasize it, and those are the main thing you pay for. We're going for SSL now. What is SSL? SSL is a security feature on your site. It actually means secure socket layer. I know you must have seen on some website you see a padlock sign. That sign shows that this site is secure. You can do transactions with them. Your data will not be easily, you understand, hacked. So SSL is very important. It's very, very, very important. Even to rank on Google, if you don't have an SSL, you're not wrong. There's a time my SSL expired and I noticed my ranking fell. Immediately I paid for SSL again. Immediately I started ranking. Okay, we cannot overemphasize SSL. Okay, SSL is important. Set up WordPress. Yeah, we know WordPress, I've said it before. WordPress is a CMS, okay? A CMS that help you manage your content. You don't need coding with WordPress. I know lots of people have been saying WordPress. If you go online, you see you learn WordPress. You learn how to build website without coding. And it has lots of features. With WordPress, can build almost any type of site. There are other CMS out there. There's Joomla, there's Wix, and pretty much many of them out there that you can use. But WordPress is multi-feature. It has so many functions, you understand, and very popular. WooCommerce is a plugin. This is a plugin that converts your website into a store, an online store. You convert it into mini Jumia. So you want a mini Jumia store, this plugin is very important. Okay, it's called WooCommerce, and I think they don't have any competition in terms of plugins. I'm here to see a plugin that can overturn WooCommerce. In WooCommerce, you learn how to add products. All these are under WooCommerce. And also themes. There are WooCommerce themes also that can help you make your website look very nice. Okay, we're going to be looking at the themes. How to install other plugins. Okay, there are other plugins involved that you need to learn how to install. That needs like a contact form. You need some SEO plugin, SEO plugin also that will help you. Okay, this is for a company website. I'm just putting this for goods because they're almost the same thing. The thing you need, the only difference between that one and this is just WooCommerce. Let me just tell you the truth. With what I'm going to be teaching, you can make almost any type of site. I'm telling you, you can even make a social media site, you can make a forum site, you can make a membership site. Okay, this first section here is talking about the back end of the site. Domain hosting, SSL, and certificates setup. This one is talking about the front end, this from WordPress on. Everything we are going to be learning at the end of the tutorial, I am actually giving you a way to put it into practice. This is not just theoretical something, or it's not something that you just hear and just go and sit down, or you just sweep it under your carpet. Because the monetization of your website might not work the best way that it's supposed to work. Maybe because you probably had all the teachings here and you don't put it into practice. You have to put it into practice. You have to try it out. You have to work hard to see results. Forget everything everything they are telling you online, nothing good comes easy. You have to put effort. This is not MMM or a Ponzi scheme that you just make money just like that. You need to put on hard work and you see the result. I'll be happy to see you on the inside.